it's easy to take, amen, but it's going to cost you something.
That's right.
Easy come, easy go. God said he made rich and had no sorrow. When God give me something, I'll be able to hold on. I don't care. Can't nobody take it away from me. And guess what? I don't have to tell anybody about it. They're going to already know that God blessed me. Because he's going to be looking good, amen. They're going to say, man, what happened? Where'd you get that suit from? Or where'd you get that house, that car? They're going to know God bless you.
Right.
You ain't got to tell one person.
That's right.
That's why they're going to know you're saved. That's why I say it's a difference.
Yeah.
People know you're saved because your light going to be shining. You ain't going to be hanging out with the bad people on the job. You're going to be doing a day's work. Because if you got a good taste of the Lord, you're going to give them 8 hours of work. I guarantee you that. You ain't going to be hiding out in the loft. You ain't going to be just hiding out. You just riding the clock, what we call it. You're going to give them 8 hours. When your break time comes, you take a break. When work time comes, you go back to work. But you got to have a good taste in order to do that. I know it worked because I used to ride the clock. But when I started working for Jesus, I couldn't ride it no more. They just get my check, but I'm working for Jesus, amen. That's who I'm working for. Brother, you said the lady saw something different in you. Brother, let nothing take you away from church. If you can make it, I go to work every Sunday morning. But I refuse. It's a sacrifice to be here. Because I know what it means to me. See, you gotta remember, you fall down fast and you go up.
That's
right. So brother, try to make it every chance you get.
Amen.
Don't let the devil steal anything from you.
Right.
I really enjoyed your testimony. Because the young lady already saw something in you.
Amen.
And guess what? God got more. Amen. But you gotta get a good taste of it. Once you get a good taste of it, you're gonna sacrifice.
Right.
What I do is a sacrifice. I go to work every Sunday morning.
Amen.
It's a sacrifice. But God will renew you. And give you strength in order to hold on. That's what it's going to take. I know it's going to take this for me. If I quit coming to church, amen, I'm going to backslide. And when I backslide, I go back and start doing the same old stuff that I used to do. Start wasting my money over and over again. Start cheating on my wife over and over again. Start give me a girl over here. Give me one over here. Give me some 22s and lay the seat back. But when I get a good taste of the Lord, see, I ain't worried about going back there. It's a sacrifice. You gotta make a sacrifice in the life that we're living in. Because the devil done given up. He done went to another level, amen. That's why we gotta hold on to God's unchanging hand. We change, but God never changed. I told somebody to hold on to God's unchanging hand. God never changed, but sometimes we change. We gotta hold on to God's unchanging hand. They say when the blessing goes up, the praises come down. We gotta bless God, amen. We gotta bless God when we're doing good. We gotta bless God when we're doing bad. We gotta bless God when we don't feel so good. We gotta bless God every chance we get. Because the devil knows that you can praise your way out. But I tell somebody to hold on. To God's unchanging hand. David said, I look to the hills, he's coming by help. David realized that his help comes from the Lord that made heaven and he made earth. I tell you to hold on to God's unchanging hand. But we got to get a good taste to do it. The devil needs to sift you like wheat. That's what he want to do. He want to run you through a system. And when you come out of there, you be just like flour, amen. That's how he want. That's what Jesus told Peter. He want to run you through the system. Because you're so out of him, you gave him up. And you start coming to church and trying to do right. But Paul said, every time I try to do good, evil is present. I come to tell you this morning, just hold on, amen. Just keep praising the Lord, regardless how the situation looks. They can be laying everybody else off. But I tell you what, they won't lay you off. If you got a good taste of the Lord, I tell you to hold on to God's unchanging hand. I tell you, he's all right. You are having witness in the house. I tell you, the Lord is all right. I know he's all right. the Lord. Hallelujah. It ain't about us. It's all about God, amen. If we forget about ourselves, we will be able to win it and stay in the race. It ain't given to the sinners, amen. It ain't given to her faith. It's given to the one that endures. But you can endure some temptation. God can be able to deliver you out. Baby, say, I bless him. I don't care what's. The mortgage should be doing him a blessing. The job can be ran off of him a blessing. Everything can be in disarray. I'm a blessing. And that's what we got to get in our spirit. And once we get a taste of man, we can be able to bless him.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. And that's continually. When your kids get on your nerves, you got a blessing. Amen. And I know your kids get on your nerves, but I, when Chris stayed with me, amen, me and her were just alike. We ate the same food, and she wanted my food, and my wife was two against one. I told her, we had a hard time, but I hold on, amen. It ain't fair having two against one. I know it's female, but they were wearing me a new one, amen. Living with two women in the same house. Amen.